respected principal, vice principal, Adam officer, senior master, academic and Adam staff, PTA staff, good morning to you all. Teachers Day commemorates the birth anniversary of Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, a scholar, a Bharat Ratna recipient, the first vice president and second president of independent India. He was born on September 5, 1888. As the name suggests, the day is dedicated to teachers and acknowledge their contribution in shaping the future citizens of the country. The objective is to remember and remind the crucial role teachers play in molding the students' life and career. Teaching is a profession that teaches all other professions. Prime Minister Modi says teaching is not a profession but a way of life, that is, Jeevandar. He also says teachers to understand changes that is happening across the world so that they can prepare the new generation to face them. He goes on to say, teachers' determination and sincerity will shape the destiny of the nation as they are laying foundation and building blocks of the society. May I now request our principal sir to light the lamp and garland the photo of Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. Sir, please. Thank you, sir. May I now request Shri P.M. Osuf, sir, to please come and give his speech on the occasion. Sir, please.
Nicholas Sparks once said, they inspire you, they entertain you, and you end in learning a time even you don't know about it. Good morning to you all, respected principal, vice principal, madam officer, my learned colleagues, administrative staff, PTI, and all my friends. Today, we celebrate the Teachers Day. We know Teachers Day is celebrated to respect and honor the hard work and contribution of the teachers of the society. In India, we do celebrate it on 5th September as the birth date of Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, who is the second president of India. We have postponed it to 7th since former president Mr. Pranab Mukherjee expired. So we are celebrating it on 7th September 2020. Now, in the world, Teachers' Day is celebrated on 5th October from 1966 onwards. And it is celebrated to assess the contributions of the teachers to society and evaluate what are the facilities to be provided to the teachers for improving the present educational system. The theme of World 2020 Teachers' Day celebration, as per UNESCO, is Teachers Leading in Crisis, Reimagining the Future. The organization has dedicated this day to the teaching profession worldwide to take stock of achievements and draw attention to the voices of teachers who are the heart of efforts to attain the global education target of leaving no one behind. You know, COVID pandemic has put a break to all activities that were taking place in the world. So, education, all activities. So the teachers have got the important role to solve the problems of the students of the society or India society, we can say. They have to provide education to the children and to the remotest villages where there are no facilities. There are vulnerable population due to the corona. And schools, see, we are only now every year we'll have a lot of students sitting in front of us. Today we are only person. So we cannot open the schools. So it is our responsibility, the teacher's responsibility, to lead the society the way it is expecting of us. Aristotle said, man is by nature a social animal. So the corona atmosphere has made us not to be a social animal. Everywhere we are asked to keep social distance. So this corona has to be controlled, or in our day-to-day life, we must make the students feel happy. So if teaching profession is not, the teachers are not there, if we are not conducting the online classes, we cannot keep the students in at home. You know, keeping the students under control for some time is very difficult. So if they don't have any activities, keeping them at home is very difficult. They say, it was being told, if the schools are not there, the mental asylums would have been filled with the mothers. So, and you think the present situation where children cannot go out and play, they should be kept inside. So the effort that we put up by teaching, take out their energy and use them for the betterment of the society. Once Vivekananda said about education, education means enabling the mind to find out that ultimate truth which emancipates us from the bondage of dust and gives us wealth not of things but of inner light, not of power but of love. It's a process of enlightenment. We may think it is a philosophical explanation. It is not a philosophical explanation. If a teacher can bring out what is inside the student and make him creative, that is education. If we know our abilities and talents, we would have been more productive and more creative. So it is our responsibility, our duty and responsibility to bring out the abilities and knowledge of a student. China. This is the reason why Antonio France has told. The art of teaching is only art of awakening the natural curiosity of young minds for the purpose of satisfying it afterwards. So, we must bring out the curiosity in the minds of the child. Then only we can educate him. And that curiosity makes him to create or do something in the world. If he has no curiosity, he will sit lazy and wasted. To create curiosity, and I want to know, inquisitive mind should be created in the brain of the child. In ancient period, we had a gurukula system. Students used to go to the teachers' houses, stay there, study. And the teachers were respected by the students as well as the society. And the society would provide whatever is needed for the teacher without even asking. So the teachers could contribute entirely for the child. He need not worry about anything other than teaching, other than being with the child. But the system, teacher has got more responsibility. Because every action of the teacher is looked at by the student. So that is a system in Sainik schools. If we speak a word, if we behave something, everything is seen by the student. So we, being in the Sainik school, have got more responsibility to behave in the perfect and expected way by the society. So our importance is because the profession of the teachers affect the shape of the earth and even changes the shape of the earth. Sometimes you might have heard the statement, those who can't do, teach. You may think it's a negative statement. I don't think. I think it's a positive statement. Because if a teacher is 100% perfect, what you can teach is new student to achieve something? And 100% has come, nothing more. So the teacher cannot be 100%. So if he gives little gap, then that gap will be filled by the student when he completes his education. That's the teacher. So we should be like that. Permit them to complete the gap. So that is the education system. No plant can grow only with the manure and water. It needs warmth of the sun. And the warmth and confidence to a child is provided by the teacher. So our activities. I have a request to the parents of the society or the teachers. Group of everybody. Please never criticize your teacher in front of your child. Once you criticize the teacher, in front of your child, you draw a curtain between the teacher and you, or the child. So when more and more you criticize, the curtain becomes more and more dark. So the student cannot see the teacher. The student cannot understand what the teacher tells because he has put a curtain. So please, never criticize your teacher in front of your child. I am not telling the others, society should not criticize the teacher. Society has got the right to criticize the teacher and guide the teachers and correct the teachers if they do mistake. But not in front of your own child. Please be careful about it. Whatever the reasons, and if the child comes with the idea to criticize her, telling the teacher is wrong, please correct your child and tell, my dear child, he is your teacher and he is a human being also. He also may do mistakes. That's important. So let us come to another point of Vivekananda. Once Vivekananda has told, Guru must be worshipped as God. He is God. So even if we are unhappy with God, we do not criticize God. We just bear and accept it. So please bear with us, the teachers, and that directly to the teacher, not to the students, not to tell the students that their teacher is like this, teacher is like, you know, you like this. Please never tell in front of your own children. And to any child, when the child has grown up, he is able to understand, let him, no objection. But when he is a child, please remember in your mind. At last, I would like to quote Yogi Narsha. I am only a fellow traveler of whom you ask the way. I pointed ahead of myself as well as. So let us work it together and create a better society where all of us can live a happy life. Thank you very much.